Hello, I'd like to show you how to convert a context-free grammar to a regular tree grammar. And to give you a better understanding of what's going on, I will first create an example tree for you. And if you are deriving a string from the context-free grammar, then you will of course start with the start symbol, and I will just start with the rule. So in the derivation tree, I will get an sroot node, which has two daughter nodes called A and B. And then when I have the A, I can only derive it to the terminal A, so this A will get a daughter node called A. And the B, for the B I have two possible rules. I can either derive it to the start symbol, or I can derive it to the terminal B. I will go with the start symbol first, just to show you what's going on. Then I will take the first rule again, deriving S to A and B. Then of course my A will derive again to a terminal A, and the B. Now the B, I will derive the B to the terminal B, and I will get something like this. And A, well, I took the wrong color for this one, but this rule is just the same as this one. So, now as you may remember, the context-free grammar is a string language which generates the strings, and the rules doesn't matter. The rules don't matter. And that's why you can convert context-free grammar into Chomsky normal form or into another canonical form and change the rules, but the string language will stay the same. But that's not true for the regular tree grammar, because for the regular tree grammar, the trees matter. And if you have a context-free grammar that generates the same string language but use different rules, then it will convert to another regular tree grammar. So now we want to create the regular tree grammar. And the regular tree grammar consists, let me call it G1. It consists of four parts. And the parts are a set of new non-terminal symbols. Then we will have a new start symbol, which I will call S1, and which is also an element of the non-terminal symbols. Then I will have an alphabet of terminal strings, which will be the same as in our start grammar. And then we will have a set of rules. And I think you can figure out those three parts easily on your own. But what's most interesting is the set of rules, and I will show you how to get the rules. And of course we will now start with a new start symbol, so we have a different set of non-terminal symbols additional to the ones we have here. And when we have a start symbol, well, in either case, on the left side we will have a non-terminal symbol from this set, and on the right side we will generate a tree, and the tree we are now generating is the one that corresponds to those S node, and the S node will have two daughter nodes because I have only this rule and the two daughters are A and B. So I will just include two new non-terminal symbols, which I call N1 and N2. So now I can derive an S node tree with two daughter nodes, and I don't know yet what those daughter nodes will include, but that's what I will do in the next step. So in the next step, let me take the N1 node, and I want to find a rule that derives me those daughter tree with A on top, or with A as root and with a terminal A as daughter, and that's what I write down like this, because it's in the bracket format for trees. And well, you may think, Well, I could just include those A subtree into this part because it will be the same anyway. Well, that's true. It's just a choice I made to create this as a different rule to show you the similarities between the tree language and the context-free grammar. And so I decided to make this a new rule that generates me those subtree, but I could also include those A subtree into this part where N1 is at the moment. I could also decide to not include a terminal A in this part, but to include a new non-terminal symbol like N3 and then write N3 derives to my terminal A. But that's another choice I made and that you can make as well when you derive your own trees. So, and now I want to derive the right side of the S subnode. And I will use the new N2. And in any case, the right subnode of the right daughter node of the S will be a B. So there's no choice in it. But, I can make different choices here as well. I can either decide to include just one non-terminal symbol, a new one that derives to either the S node or to the B terminal, but I can also do it this way. I can say, well, my B will either have a subnode which is the start symbol, so I can go through all those processes again, through all those derivation processes. Or I can say that the derivation will end here and the daughter node of the B will be a terminal B. So this, these brackets tell me that that in the middle of the brackets are daughter nodes, and this pipe symbol is an OR that tells me which daughter node I can include. And that's basically it. If you just follow those simple steps, then you can convert any context-free grammar to a regular tree grammar that generates exactly the derivation trees of the context-free grammar.